You start out with a sealed tank that contains 5 liters of water, liquid phase, and 20 liters in the vapor phase, and it's at 50 degrees C. We then add 2 liters of an ionic liquid without changing the volume of the tank. The ionic liquid is soluble in water, but it has essentially zero vapor pressure. It's an isothermal system, so we're still at 50 degrees C. The question is, what happens, and explain why. It helps to visualize what our system is, so drawings won't be to scale, but the idea is we start out with 5 liters of water. This is liquid. And then the vapor is 10 liters. So water vapor, vapor liquid equilibrium pressure would be the saturation pressure. We end up with 7 liters of the mixture. And since it's a fixed volume, we have 8 liters of vapor. And the question is, what's in the vapor? Since the saturation pressure of the ionic liquid is zero, the vapor is all water vapor. Now, as we add the ionic liquid to liquid water, we've lowered the mole fraction. So we've lowered the mole fraction of the water. We've diluted it with ionic liquid, which means we've decreased the fugacity of the water. Right? So fugacity of the water is lower, and this means the pressure above the water is lower. If this were an ideal system, the pressure of the water above it would be related to the mole fraction of the water and the saturation pressure. Well, can't argue that it's ideal, but we do argue that we've decreased this enough that we've lowered the vapor pressure. So therefore, some water must condense. Now, this happens really for two reasons. One, we have less vapor volume. So even if the partial pressure of water, in this case the pressure of water, stayed constant, the decreased volume of the vapor means that some would condense. But then additionally, some condenses because the pressure of the water decreases in the gas phase because the fugacity is lower. Fugacity is lowered in the liquid phase, which means it must be lower in the vapor phase to be at vapor-liquid equilibrium.